If you're a surfer, you look for all types of waves, like long waves at Rincon Point in Santa Barbara with Rennie Yater. Even longer rides at Rincon with Bob Cooper. Or a beach break at the oil piers with Bob Barron. Or maybe you like Hawaii, a shore break at the Banzai Pipeline. Watch Bob Beetle go straight up and down the Banzai Pipeline in Hawaii. Butch Van Arsdellen, the king of the pipeline, disappeared. We go to Sunset Beach with Ronnie McLeod. Or maybe you get locked in at the pipeline with John Peck. Or take the tunnel ride with Butch Van Arsdellen. He was so happy, he gave himself an applause. Now we know what kind of beaches. Let's fly to Hawaii. Met at the airport by a group of local surfers from the North Shore telling me that the town of Kailua had the biggest waves they've ever seen in 10 years. And I got just enough film to get the five biggest waves and the five worst wipeouts in Kailua in 10 years. Meanwhile, back on the North Shore, Mike Doyle taking off at Haleiwa. Chuck Lennon disappears. Chuck Lennon is from Long Beach, California. He comes right back out. Chuck is noted for his fancy pullouts. Well, Mike Henson right behind him. Mike Henson, another surfer from California. Again, we have Mike Doyle from Inglewood. Mike is now making surfboards in Cardiff for Henson, called the Mike Doyle model. Mike really gets locked in this hollow wave. Haleiwa is situated just south of Sunset Beach in Hawaii. Fred Van Dyke, a school teacher, takes off on the nose. He just keeps going across the wave. And Mike catches one of the bigger waves of the day. Some surfers never made the lineup, while others like Butch Van Arsdellen switching his stance at the top. He got tired of surfing so long that he decided to sit it out. And while he sits it out, let's move further on down the coast to a place called Chun's Reef. Offshore winds and almost perfect glassy conditions. Phil Edwards, the king. George Downey riding a 11-foot board. Watch this cutback right into the soup. Sometimes, if you're lucky, you can get a nice long left right. Mike Doyle shot this picture of me. This is the first wave I ever caught at Chun's Reef. After that, we moved further on down the coast and we picked up Rusty Miller at Laniakea. Phil Edwards again, playing with the wave. Laniakea has got a hidden reef, and you'll notice this surfer going over the top of the reef right here, and the wave increases in size. It passes over the reef, and the wave gets smaller. Phil Edwards. Rusty Miller catches the last two waves. You can really see how fast this beach really is. On the next wave, watch how Rusty passes over the two reefs at Laniakea. Here he's going over the first now. Passes it, he's back into the deep water. He's reaching the second reef, and watch him increase in speed. George Downey was tired of surfing so long, he just sat him out. Banzai Pipeline. This is considered one of the most dangerous beaches in the world because below the wave, only 4 feet, man from Australia screaming through this wave. Midget Fairley, winner of the 1963 Makaha Championships, also from Australia. Rusty Miller with a big drop. Jackie Eberle from Hawaii screaming across the hollow wave. Buzzy Newble right behind him. Jackie gets a late takeoff and ends up going over the falls and just missing his board. Butch Van Arsdale, the king of the pipeline, with his quick turns and his fancy pullouts. Sammy Lee locked in. Butch Van Arsdale, king of the pipeline. Just a few hundred yards away is a place called the gas chamber. For obvious reasons. David Jackman with his Australian baggies he's got on. love to have you guys drop in anytime. David Jackman again from Australia. Later on in the evening, the waves were picking up in size and speed. Look at the lines just picking up outside. Charlie Cariff from Australia gets completely locked in. And real late that evening, just before the sun went down, Jim Graham from California. Charlie Cariff from Australia tucks underneath a wave. While Jim Graham takes off behind him. And right behind Jim was Chuck Lennon, also from Long Beach, California. Gets the last wave. And early the next morning, Waimea Bay. Big one. Mickey Dora went out first, and it was overhead. We moved in for a closer look. Butch Van Artstellen. First time anyone's ever switched stance at Waimea Bay. Butch Van Artstellen, switching stance. Left foot, then right foot forward. Greg Knoll, the bull. Peter Cole looks down and sees Mike Hansen getting completely covered by the whitewater. Mike Diffendorfer makes his long wall at Waimea. Now watch Mickey Dora. He lifts his hands up in the air. Now follow it across the screen. There goes his hands so the camera can follow him. This surfer's first day out at Waimea Bay. I think it was his last. Everybody peeled off to watch Butch Van Artstellen with a tremendous ride, dropping down to the bottom, climbing up to the top, switching stance, and dropping right into the hook again. This wave got so big and covered Jose Angel up, it blocked the sun out. Jose Angel at Waimea Bay. And late that evening, catching the last ride, was the bull, Greg Knoll, dropping straight down at Waimea Bay. Sunset Beach, Hawaii's answer to Malibu. With all the people that have been surfing there this year, it's surprising there hasn't been that many accidents. They came down on their stomachs. So the only way you could ride was to ride the inside waves like Peter Cole was doing. Keep away from the crowd. Rusty Miller catches a wave outside, all to himself. The new hydroplane board going into orbit. Later that evening, it looked like the wind was picking up offshore. Lima Columba in the yellow board almost gets hit with the board. Paul Gebauer on a glassy wave at sunset. George Downey does a dangerous thing, going left at sunset, right over the coral heads. Dewey Weber with a big drop at sunset and making the wave. Got so crowded on this wave that Mike Doyle had no choice. He had to go left. But made up for it on this next ride. Mike Doyle at Sunset Beach. Butch Van Arsdelen again walked away with top honors. Completely locked in, a hollow wave at Sunset Beach. About a mile or so from that beach, there's another beach called Velzyland. The surfer you're gonna see, John Peck. Notice how he rides with his feet on the inside rail. Watch how his tail block pops out of the water. He slides down the face of the wave and manages to pull out while sitting on the nose. Late that evening, Mike Doyle went out to catch a few waves all to himself. Now watch closely on the next wave. This is the most unbelievable thing I've ever seen him surfing. You'll see a surfer come out of this wave. His name is Butch Linden, completely locked inside a wave at Velzyland. Here he comes, right out of the tube. After that ride, we decided to move back to California to a well-known spot called Rincon, located just south of Santa Barbara. Midget from Australia making friends with Bob Barron. And Bob Cooper said, let's go surfing. So that's what Midget did. Stalling on the back of his board all the way across the point at Rincon, Midget Fairley from Australia. Into a stall. Right behind him, Gino Brady doesn't like to get wet, so he holds up the wave with his hand. All right, here comes another section. Hold it up, Gino. And right behind him was Johnny Fain from Malibu, ripping the waves apart. Mm-hmm. right behind him. Getting locked in a beautiful little wave here. Starts to throw over and Terry crouches right beneath the curl. Now, Rincon is noted for many things, like dogs and goats, Bob Cooper. Occasionally, you'll see a few whales jumping outside. But here's a big 20-foot black shark cruising through the bay. Look at the tail coming behind it. Surfers try to beat the shark over the head with the fronts of their boards, while others try to beat him with their arms. Some didn't know which way to go, and some were just plain confused. But after the shark left, storm came in and the waves got bigger, and out at the first point, on the nose, Johnny Fane is on the nose now, but just to be sure, he's getting a little bit closer. Mike Doyle was in the islands this year in 1963, broke his hand, came back the next day. A week later, he was surfing Rincon with a plastic bag and a bandage over his right hand. Paul Strau Jr. came over for the weekend, and here he is getting ready to hang 10. So while he's hanging 10, let's leave Rincon for a while and move with Johnny Fane and Mickey Dore to Haggerty's in South Bay, Hermosa Beach. At the power plant in Oxnard, California, with Lance Carson serving some pretty fair waves, but the reason he was out was because the water temperature was 75 degrees, and the reason was the sewer pipes going right underneath the sand, right underneath the surfers. Lance Carson. Lance couldn't believe how warm the water was. It was just like Hawaii. We're heading back. back into Santa Barbara with Bob Cooper. Maybe a ad for Laguna Swimwear. To seeing how the swim trunks hold up in all types of conditions. Out because our matador left. Meanwhile, we got to the sand spits inside our harbor in Santa Barbara with Lance Carson on the nose. These are the biggest waves ever filmed at this beach. It was during a storm in 1963. While Lance was out in the water surfing, the Coast Guard and police were moving boats out of the harbor. Part of the pier collapsed, and then telling Lance he's going to get killed because he's just missing the pilings where the boats were tied. You'll see him go right by him. It looks just like snow when he stalls on the board here. Powder snow. Dedicate this next section to all those who are just beginning to surf. It's called The Wipeout. These are some of the worst wipeouts in Hawaii and California, 1963. This surfer thought he had it made. Almost chopped off. No matter where you surf, you can always look forward to the wipeout. No matter who you are, you always get the big drop. Thank you. imagine a Saturday morning, waves from 3 to 4 feet, and you're the only surfer out for 5 hours. Midget Fairley from Australia. Ruler waves from one edge of the screen to the other, a straight line. Sorry to get a little crowded here. Midget was on one wave and the surfer behind him was on another. Midget was a little concerned on what would happen if he lost his board, because on shore there's hundreds and hundreds of rocks sticking up. Well, the surfer in front of Midget lost his board. And he found out that you don't have to worry, because there's always somebody there to pick him up. Bernie Yeater seems pleased. And Midget could care less. So let's leave Hammonds and move to Rincon. To see John Eicher and Bob Cooper, the Smith brothers, checking the surf out. I said the surf. Let's get back to the surf. And we see Midget taking off at the first point at Rincon. Midget is truly walking on the wet side. On the nose outside. Watch the waves squeak them right out. A beautiful cutback. And Midget right behind him. Late in the evening shot of Kenny Kesson outside the sparkling cool water. Kenny seems to have a lot of fun with the waves, and as he pulls out, he waves goodbye to the wave. Johnny Fain was having a little trouble outside. This time he thought he'd try it in reverse. Mike McDowell inside, getting right under the tip. Harold Iggy on the nose, screaming through the inside sections. Pete Holworth was body surfing and got a few waves to himself. In Rincon, you find all types of styles, and this guy had his own. Jimmy Gray was riding an 11-foot board, and he heard some noise behind him. And it was Johnny Jett screaming along the way. Bob Cooper, small inside wave, watch him while he's in the soup, trim his board, walk up and hang five. Gets hit by a surfer paddling out. Bill Fury from Seal Beach gets a beautiful little wave. Randy Yater, who makes surfboards in Santa Barbara, likes to see some of the boards go on the rocks because I think he makes a little business that way. And here it is at high tide, Randy Yater relaxing while he sees the surfer in front of him going headfirst into the rocks. There goes the board climbing the rocks about now. Then there were two. Keep off. Keep off the nose. It's got to be Lance Carson. Watch how this surfer sort of surfs with the music. And always on the nose. Lance Carson. Beautiful bottom turn by Lance. And notice how he goes around all the surfers and body surfers in the water. Carson was riding the wave and he heard some noise behind him, and it was Mickey Munoz. Mickey makes those trunks himself. Lance Carson inside the sandbar at Rincon. Lance proved a point that's been argued for many years. Lance proved that Rincon can be ridden at any size. other surfers coming in. Just before the sun sets, we pick up Bob Barron at the oil piers in Santa Barbara. Beautiful shape waves. Surf was picking up in California, and we had an idea that we better get back to Hawaii. And we heard Mike Doyle was going to jump off the falls at Waimea. So we filled up the water full of jello boxes. So when Mike was going to jump in, he didn't know what was going to happen, but we did. So let's get to the islands and watch Mike jumping into Waimea Falls. Uncle tried it. Then I got real brave, and then I tried it. We're on our way to Haleiwa on the North Shore. We got lost, so we asked the first person we came to which way was Haleiwa. He said, just go straight down this road. It turns into a better road, like a freeway. And just follow the freeway all the way down to Haleiwa. So we were on our way, but we couldn't figure out why this Marine was laughing. The whole time we had a funny feeling we were being watched, but we weren't being watched. Chuck Lennon said, if that's all the Army's gonna do, he's gonna join up. Then he heard some noise behind him, and it was Haleiwa breaking. Mike Doyle salutes the wave. Lewy, a boy with polio, riding the big waves at Haleiwa. Chuck Lennon slides down the wave, right with the soup. Mike Henson again. Stephen Petty riding a 7-foot board.